you can talk bad things about yourself, or you can decide to choose to talk great things about yourself. You are the one in control of this. But many go through life are not aware of what they talk to themselves, especially when bad events, when bad things happen into their life, when stress happens. They decide to give a meaning to that bad event, that they are not good enough, they are not worthy, and that they are inadequate. They decide to choose to talk bad things about themselves. That's what happened to almost every one of us, including me, because we have a tendency to focus on what we lack. And when we don't have what we want, when things go different than what we anticipated, we often doubt ourselves and talk bad things about ourselves. But over time, what I realize is, what good does it do when we talk bad about ourselves, when we don't think highly out of ourselves? Nothing. Nothing good actually happens when we talk bad about ourselves. But here's the trap. This is why that we often talk bad about ourselves. It's because we subconsciously, I emphasize on this, we subconsciously think that if we tell ourselves that we are a loser, we are a failure, then nobody would expect anything from us, right? In the short term, in a moment, we remove that pressure so we feel good. Hey, if I'm a loser, if I'm not good enough, so I will not do anything. I will not do any great thing in our life, so nobody would expect anything from me, right? In a moment, you feel like you remove that pressure, and it's giving you like a feeling like, okay, I feel good. I have a permission to fail. But that is an illusion, my friend. That is a trap that so many of us fall into. Yes, in a moment, it may feel good, but then what? Most people don't know is they just use that over and over again, and over time they start to believe it. They start to believe that they are a failure, they are a loser, and they settle for that status quo. They settle for being a loser, they settle for being a failure, a person that never do any great thing in their life. And that is the dangerous thing about how you talk to yourself. When you talk bad thing about yourself, it do nothing good besides drain your energy, make you doubt yourself, make you question yourself, make you reduce your confidence, make you feel like you are inadequate, make you feel like you are not good enough. That's why it's so crucial that you talk great things about yourself, even if initially you don't really believe it, but then keep going at it, keep forcing it. I know there are many times it's not easy to talk great things about yourself, because the time that when we fall short, we hate ourselves for those times, right? When we fall short, when we don't meet a target, we often disappoint ourselves, and we often doubt ourselves and like hate ourselves. It's okay to be angry at ourselves in a moment, but be careful about the language that you use in those moments. Avoid saying something like, I am a loser, I am not good enough, I am a failure. Avoid saying I am with a negative attachment, because when you say I am, it's like a permanent thing. When you say I am, make sure you attach it with a positive word, like I am confident, I am abundant, I am energetic, I am passionate, I am determined, I am persistent, I am attractive. It's so important that you attach the I am statement with a positive words. Right now, even when you say it, if you say I am a loser, you feel like you are defeated. You feel like you don't want to take any action. You feel so inadequate about yourself. You feel so doubt about yourself. But even if right now you say I am confident, I am abundant, you automatically feel good about yourself. You feel like you can accomplish anything in life. So when you like fall short, when bad event happen into your life, and when you don't meet targets, you can say like, okay, I failed at this time, but I learned a great lesson, and I will try again and again. I will make another attempt. You see how the language I use? You say I fail at this time. Why? Because it's already happened. It's in the past. It's only temporary. I fail in the past. I fail at this time. It doesn't mean that I will fail again in the future. So it's give you a chance. It's give you hope that you can try again. And that you can succeed in the future. The most dangerous self-talk that you need to avoid at all costs is stop saying, I can't. That's the dangerous thing. If you say, I can't do this. I can't overcome this challenge. I can't make that much amount of money. I can't afford that. Avoid saying those things. Avoid saying, I can't. Remove that vocabulary from your brain. Instead of saying, I can't, saying, I will try this time. If you want to make that much amount of money, okay, I will try different methods. I will try to take more jobs. I will try to improve my skills. You can say, I can try. I will try. Don't say, I can't. Because when you say, I can't to yourself, you literally stop you from accomplishing great things in your life. You stop hoping. You stop dreaming. And when you don't see any hope, you will no longer try. You will no longer put in the effort. You will no longer want to take action. Practice positive self-talk regardless of your progress. It's so important that even when you fall short, even when you don't meet your target, still talk great things about yourself. Even when you don't get a phone number that you anticipated, still talk great things about yourself. Even when your YouTube channel doesn't have that amount of audience that you wanted, still talk great things about yourself. Even when you don't get promoted, still talk great things about yourself. It doesn't matter how much you make and your progress this week, talk great things about yourself. And when you believe that you are confident, you are abundant, you already have everything you needed, you will want to take more actions. And when you take more actions, you will make that statement come true. You will make your dreams come true. So the key takeaway is, be aware. Be mindful of what you talk to yourself. Many times and very often times, we talk bad things about ourselves because it's happened subconsciously. We do it unconsciously, that we wasn't even aware of what we talk to ourselves. But you know how powerful our subconscious is. When you talk bad things about yourself, when you talk things that you don't want yourself to be, you subconsciously act according to what you talk to yourself, what you believe, what you actually believe about yourself. So make sure you be aware and make sure you be mindful of what you talk to yourself. Remember, it all starts with awareness. Because when you are aware of it, you will learn to talk great things and grateful things to yourself. I'm convinced that our quality of life greatly depends on how you see yourself. So start seeing a potential within yourself. Start seeing yourself as a confident, a grateful, a kind, abundant, optimistic, amazing. You have everything you needed. You are enough. And the most importantly, you are an action taker. I hope you enjoy this episode. I just want to say thank you for choosing my podcast. Appreciate your review, and until next time, thank you.